Alright, we're back. We got this window open. I don't know. Sort of was screwing around for a second. We're gonna go back to this. We're gonna go to upload. Not a whole lot of views yet, but I'm kind of uploading this stuff in rapid fashion. And it's gonna sit online. Because why not? Good times 5. Open. Start doing that. Alright. So, we kind of made this memory jump up a little bit in the last video. You can see that spike right here. Did it go up massively like we predicted? No. Why didn't it? Well, we were appending such a small value, zero, appending that value onto a list. You know, it's just not chewing up enough memory in a fast enough way. So all kinds of crazy dynamic memory stuff going on behind the scenes. And, you know, it's probably minimizing that and has all sort of like, you know, some on-the-fly data compression and delta stuff. I don't know. There's probably something like that. Anyway, see if we can make this better. So we're gonna do this again. We're gonna do that again. We're screwing around. We're not really talking about what we're doing. Let's maybe touch on it for a second. What are we doing? Well, first thing we're doing is we're making a variable x. We're making it a list data structure. Wikipedia is the place to go if you want to start typing in, you know, like lists, and then like disambiguate based on data structure. I'm sure something like that is a massive article all about lists or lists. And as a matter of fact, we were looking up Lisp as the programming language in a couple videos back, and it's sort of built around the whole list data structure. So, you know, you could maybe go to Lisp, and then you could read about lists. How ridiculous is that? Pretty damn similar. Go to Lisp to read about list. The list. Go to Lisp to read about the list. That's all we're going to say. Then we have this thing, while one. What's that doing? Well, it's basically just saying, you know, it just run whatever's indented underneath right here, just run this forever. I don't care. I don't ever want to have to deal with the fact that, you know, maybe I've reached some condition or whatever that, you know, I want to stop running this statement. But basically what we're doing is we're just telling the Python to tell the, you know, we're not telling the computer. We're telling Python, and then Python in turn is telling the computer. So we're telling Python to tell the computer that we just want to run whatever the hell is underneath this indent. Or the statement right here. We just want to do that forever. Till the end of time. Or till the computer crashes. Whichever comes first. I think I know which will. So how are we going to make it chew up more memory? Pretty simple. Utilize some basic rules here. Let's see. So we were having to chew up. Or we were appending the constant zero. How big is the constant zero in memory? Probably not that big. So what are we going to do? We're going to do... we're going to do this. We're going to append the entire alphabet every time. What do these quotes mean? We're specifying that this is a string. That's, in a nutshell, that's all we're going to say about that. Again, you can look it up. So we're going to hit enter, and then we'll probably have to hit enter a second time. And what's it going to do? It's much more data. It takes much more space in the computer's RAM to represent this string than it does to represent this number zero. So, each time this executes, and as we talked about, this is just executing until the end of time. Each time this executes, it's going to chew up a much larger block of memory than when we did this. So, let's do that. Keep our eye on this over here. This should start filling up relatively quickly. Hit enter twice. We rub our eye. What do we got? It's running, right? Yep, it is running. Is this filling up? Yeah, it's filling up. Again, it's going really slow. There's a whole lot of behind-the-scenes stuff that we're not incredibly clear on, but... let's just wait a second. See if it goes over 3 gigs. It does. So, again, it's taking too long. We want this to be, you know, somewhat much faster. What do we got here? 263 seconds. All right, we got some time. We're going to cut right to the chase. We're going to quit screwing around. Yeah, we messed it up. Syntax error. That's not what we want to do. We're going to say a much more dynamic way to do this. I don't really care. I'm tired of messing around with it. I'm just gonna do that. Now, as I'm doing that, I just realized that I'm being absolutely ridiculous, and I can. There's a much more dynamic way that we can do this. So we're gonna do that. Let's say x equals that. Let me see. Can we? Is there any way that we could just tell it to? Yep. We can do that. We can do that. Yeah, we can type in characters, but I don't want to do that. So I'm gonna do while one, and I gotta pull this up real quick. So we're gonna demonstrate a little bit. We gonna demonstrate it? No, probably not. There's some way for us to tell us tell Python how big of a data structure we want to make. There's a whole lot of roundabout ways that we go about doing that, but we're gonna cut right to the chase. We're gonna go to Python. Want the 2.x documentation. This is gonna give us documentation of the entire API, and we're kind of showing how ridiculous some of this stuff can be. We're gonna go sequence types. We're gonna talk about lists. Yep. Yada yada yada. Declaring them again. I don't know. I suppose I should really know how to do this, frankly. Append 3. Yep. Let's see. What we append 3 was treat it as 0. Let's copy string methods. I don't give a shit about that. I do care about that. What we're gonna do is we're gonna say x. Now that I just thought about string methods and Python being a dynamic language, we're just going to do that. And we're going to multiply this value by 1024, and that's it. And now you can see we have it right. We're going to stop this. So I was just being retarded there, but I'm demonstrating the point. Or is it clear what I'm demonstrating if you're just sort of following along and have no idea about Python or anything like that? No, it's not clear at all. But suffice to say that I have finally gotten my head on my ass, and I've figured out how we're going to write this statement. Again, I didn't do this before because I thought it would be kind of fun to watch me sort of screw around and whatnot. It's a little embarrassing because, I should have not done this. I should have not done that. I should have just jumped right to this. But that's all we're going to say about that. So we have our memory right here. We're actually going to cut this value down a little bit, so it's not so rapid. We could, now that I have my head on my ass and whatnot, we could just change this number right over here on the right, and we could chew up the all 16 gigs of memory in probably, a second flat. Maybe we'll do that at the end of the video, but we want to make it a little more progressive than that, or a little less progressive than that. You can see here that, there's a huge spike right here. That's when we finally figured it out, as the case may be. We ran this for a couple seconds, and it just shot way up, about half, a little less than half. So we're going to basically cut this down a little bit. So we can say there's x, it's a list, data structure, while one, execute this forever. We're going to append some value that we're not going to bother explaining onto this list for each element that we're going to create. So, it went up real, real fast. We cut it in half to 512, but we're gonna cut it in half again to 256. So we're gonna hit enter. It gives us something here. There's a reason why it's hanging still. It's not executing this whole stuff yet. It's sort of waiting for us to hit enter one more time and sort of really say, yep, I'm done entering instructions in, and then I'm gonna start executing this. And then as soon as we hit enter this the second time, we're gonna again look over here as I hit enter or whatnot. And then immediately start looking over here, because you're going to see that all the memory in the computer is starting to be chewed up. I am not going to stop it. I'm just going to let it go and go and go. I will stop it at some point when it gets way up here to the top, and there's all sorts of like paging and things going on. We will stop it, but let's just do it. Stop talking about it. You can see even the mouse cursor is starting to blink for me. I don't know if the video is picking it up, but even Windows is starting to slow down. It's just tons and tons and tons of memory being chewed up. You can see this, again, I have no idea what's happening in the video right now. My computer's really starting to slow down. You can see this line just shooting up. Oh, this is almost full. 13, 14 gigs, 14.8 gigs, 15 gigs. We have reached 16 gigs. Now my computer's getting ridiculous. It is just eating up everything. The mouse is starting to stutter. This is maxed out up here. This graph is not even updating anymore. Cam Studio. can we possibly stop this process? I'm not even sure. Windows as an operating system right now is absolutely just having a total fucking meltdown behind the scenes, trying to figure out how to manage this much memory consumption. I have no doubt that it cannot. Did we actually manage to end that problem? The rest of the UI, I'm going to move my mouse up. Definitely want to. Let's kill that thing. It's a time limit here. Alright, we're back. We can continue there. We can continue. We're probably going to get a lot of messages because the entire computer, all the RAM in the machine just got chewed up, and it took, you know, a minute and a half, 2 minutes to even get control back and manage to kill the process via task manager here. Look at that spike. Chewed everything up. We sat way up there. Now we got total memory. What's available? Well, you know, we got more now. Anyway, that was fun. You know, I got a chuckle out of it. So, how's this going to look when I finally stop Cam Studio? It saves the AVI and then I upload it to YouTube. I don't know. And just for purposes of amusement, I'm not going to watch the video before I upload it. I'm going to wait for it to upload and then I'll watch it. But we've beyond any person's reasonable doubt here, we have certainly demonstrated that with Python, and this is not exclusive to Python. You could write those three lines of code in any programming language. We have full control over the system and can force it to give us as much or as little memory and throw values around as much as we want. And, that was kind of fun.